Oh dear, oh dear, that could be a six. That's a great hit, straight down the ground, over Wong On. What a magnificent player. In Brisbane, he struck Trotamate over mid-off. In Perth, he goes over Wong On. Superb stroke.
And he's lifted that over the top of Long Off, and that's a big hit. That's a huge hit for six by Richards. That is a magnificent stroke. And that's gone down to Long On, over the head of Lawson, who is not right on the fence. And it crashes into the fence. Umpires are looking. And it
stump. And the third West Indies wicket is down.
Richards has hit that way down the ground into the press box. That's a ginormous six.
Just far enough to be over the red stripe sign.
I thought.
And there's definitely more room in the air if you hit them that far. That's the 400 up for the West Indies. Six runs to Vivian Richards.
Oh.
And there's no one back there, I can tell you. And I think it's gone back into the canal again.
Why he was waiting for the ball full length, and it's six. So this is a crucial stage of the innings, both for Vivian Richards and for England. Oh, that's a big hit. Now that he really did mean, and he really did middle. Previous one, he got it a little high on the splice, but that one exactly where he meant.
Sensational, but no better than that. That went through mid-wicket, whereas Hooper's went straight over square leg.
That's high, sliced away by Richards in four runs.
A beautiful six. A wonderful stroke by Vivian Richards against the off-spinner. There's a big hit. Now Viv is really opening up. It's a six.
Well, that's quite a good way to do it. Could hardly be straighter down the ground for six. Win the match, take a 2-1 lead in the series, so they can't be beaten, West Indies.
And we have a change in bowler. Greg Matthews is coming on. Now that's a big one. It's going into the crowd, carrying over Long On for six. And Viv Richards with a chance off his second ball. Australia could well rue that catch. And with this shot, Viv Richards goes to over 2,000 runs in One Day Internationals against Australia.
Big hit.
It's gone for six, hasn't it? Yes, it is. Just over the boundary, a big one by Richards.
And that is a big hit, yes. They're playing on the far wicket here, on the eastern side of the square, and that one went right over square leg. You've got to hit him pretty well to get it over that far. And Viv thinks it's going, he hasn't bothered to run. And he was right.
It's gone again. That's another big one. And Jones can't get out either. So Greg Matthews is taking some hammer here on his return to the Australian team. He's gone now for three sixes off Vivian Richards. It's three for 211.
Beautiful shot. It'll be six. Good over for the West Indies, 2 for 20.
And that's six. That's a huge hit way into the hill. Viv Richards has obviously decided that tonight is going to be his night.
And that's just as big as the one off Alderman.
Tonight, the great man Richards has risen to the occasion. The captain, he wants to go through the summer undefeated. He wants to win the Benson Hedges World Series Cup. The Test Series may be 5-0. 5 fours and 2 sixes, only 35 balls faced.
That's a magnificent shot for six. Turn inside out and hit that one over cover. What a great shot. His third six.
There was no one hand to that. That was a calculated shot. Brings up his 50. And have a look at this. Beautifully timed. He opened the face. And that's over almost a square cover at the Sydney Cricket Ground. Just pitching on about middle and leg stump. And that's the shot of a master batsman. Skill, control, just natural ability.
Pascoe to Viv Richards. And that one hit high and down towards deep mid off. There's no one down there, and it's over the top. What a magnificent shot by Vivian Richards. It didn't go that high and was hit straight down the ground and went two rows over the top of that boundary down there. Beautiful shot by Vivian Richards. A magnificent six.
And what an unusual stroke. Low, powerful, and over the top of mid-off. It's very rarely that you see a batsman sufficiently powerful enough to do that on the offside. And it really went about four rows back into the public there. It was a hit that was a danger to life and limb.
25 overs there, 3 for 81. He's a fine player of spin. He's been subdued. His partner's playing very well, Gasawagi. But now they may be scattered, and it goes right over the top of the Seagulls, and that's six. And we thought this might happen with the introduction of Bracewell. Warriors on drive.
Well, you can have him where you like. When he hits them like that, there's no way you can get him out. That went 2, 4, 6, 12, 14 rows back. Right over the top of the seats. They're situated just behind the boundary rope. What a beautiful shot.
Little dance down, 2 or 3 short steps, and then the final big one, and away it went. Crash.
Viv Richards takes strike now to Hogg.
And that's in the air, just short of the fielder. At mid-wicket, Kim Hughes came in. He was rather on his heels, seeing Richards going back for the hook shot. Richards got himself into all sorts of a tangle trying to play that ball. And lucky for him, the ball dropping short.
Yes, he certainly didn't play that very well. He decided just a little bit late, I think, that he was going to try and pull that away. Having a little chat in the middle of the pitch, interestingly, with Larry Gomes. But have a look at that. His head turned away as that ball reared up there. And Richards uncharacteristically, actually, getting himself into a bit of a tangle with that shot. So Hogg generating a bit of pace, causing Viv Richards a few problems.
Richards has hit that out of the ground. That's a mighty hit. It's gone right over the boundary at mid-wicket. A mighty hit by Richards. Haven't seen much of vintage Richards this season so far, but that was a glorious shot.
Well, that's where he likes him, around about leg stump. And just short of a length, and there it goes. Flying way over the top of that sign. And indeed, right up into the stand.
The worry captain.
2.46, the West Indies lead now. And we're starting to get into a danger area for Australia. Anything over 2.50, I reckon, is going to be pretty damn difficult to get against this West Indies attack. Merv Hughes comes into the attack now to replace Craig McDermott. And you've got to wonder if that would have occurred if he'd have taken Viv Richards' wicket in his last over. I'm sure he would have been steaming in, McDermott, to bowl the next one. Over the head of fine leg and into the crowd.
Beautiful shot this, the short pitch delivery. The greatest stroke players in the game today. He really just lunged into that. Didn't hit it with a great deal of anger. He made sure of the line, found the middle of the bat, and it easily cleared the boundary some 85, 90 metres away.
May bowled well in Brisbane in the first test, not quite so well in Perth. Sixteen rows back, and the man in the grey suit. There was a decent old smash down the ground.
I thought for a moment Viv was going to be stiff and hit the sightboard, which would have meant that he only got four. But the sightboard wasn't a problem at all. Cleared that by quite a few metres and lobbed in about the 15th row back in among the green seats there.
It's always a chance, Viv, when he plays like this. Although I guess it would be fair to say at the start of most innings, Viv's tendency is to block a couple, play a few shots. Whilst he picks up the bat as high as he does and hits as hard, there's always a chance of the missed time shot. So easily that one could have ended up in the safe hands of mid-off.
Well, it went back through Merv Hughes like a torpedo.
It's like a bullet out of a gun. Doesn't give you much chance. In fact, that may have even been a chance itself had he in fact got the hand down far enough. May have just cleaned up the end of the fingernails. Church bells in the two slips in a gully.
And Richards has clobbered that. It really wasn't that short. But he was on the back foot in a flash. And he's come out after tea and has played three top shots.
It's over number 32 for Alderman. Any stamina needed in his second innings. That one short. As yet, the new ball hasn't swung.
But just when the Australians looked set to be regaining control, Richards had the perfect answer.
Oh, look at that. Over mid-off. That's a big hit. What a magnificent shot. The 100th Test match, 36 years of age, down the ground he goes.
Hard to go past Viv Richards as the best bat.
That's an even better one. Well, if Lawson is trying to bowl for those two men down there for a catch, it's going to be a very costly business. Four and then a brilliant six. That was a lovely shot. But that's not very sensible bowling.
It certainly isn't, because of all the strokes that Richards has played in that area of backward square leg, he hasn't miscued one.
He's probably wishing he hadn't really decided to bowl. In the air, and no need to bowl. Straight into the crowd, and almost cleaved one or two of them in two. There's one bobbing his head to let it go through, and the one sitting behind is struck on the shoulder. Fantastic stroke that was.
It was flat and swift and extremely powerful. And I think it's just about to cause a depopulation of the spectators there in the...
There's an even bigger one.
that's gone way over mid on, just missing the press box and the scorer's box here, and going well back into the crowd.
What a shot this is. A little bit of power just outside off stump, and the pose there is Vivian Richards simply hits through the line and it goes miles down the ground.